Good afternoon, everybody. Myself, Subrata Saha, and the faculty member of Dr. Sudhir Chandra Shur, Institute of Sports Complex in Automobile Engineering Department. And today I am going to discuss on the topic of braking system. So what is braking system? The function of the braking system is to retard the speed of the moving vehicle or bring it to rest in the shortest possible distance whenever it required. So that is the main motto of the braking system. And one more thing, that is to braking can also control the drivers. Okay. And it converts the kinetic energy into the heat energy. The vehicle can also be held on the inclined surface against the pull of the gravity by the application of the brake. You can brake a vehicle at 30 degree or 25 degree at an angle by using the brake. That is only possible by using the brake only. And these brakes are basically the disc brake, drum brake, eddy current brakes, and all kinds of brakes are convert the kinetic energy into the heat energy. And these are the almost all of the mechanical device which is applied to the for the retardation of the vehicle speed, and it absorbs either kinetic energy or potential energy or both while remaining in action at the absorbed energy that appears in the form of heat. So the we are introducing the regenerative braking system as a electromagnetic field generation, and use that energy to change the power, like to convert or to change electromagnetic electromagnetic force to the current, and that current can be used for recharging the vehicle. Recharging the batteries. So from this formula, this kinetic energy half mv square, that is also equals to half m u square minus v square. So what is U and V? U is the initial velocity of the vehicle and V is the final velocity of the vehicle. Okay. So that is the form of kinetic energy. The main requirements of the brake. What are the main requirements of the brake? A braking system must decelerate a vehicle in a controlled and repeatable manner under a variety of different conditions, like slippery, wet and dry roads, rough and smooth roads, straight lines and cornering conditions, and high and low rates of deceleration, and new or own lining. These are also such conditions. So and next point is to permit the vehicle to travel at a constant speed during the downhill movement of the vehicle. When a vehicle is moving to the downward direction, that means your vehicle speed will automatically increase. In that case, you have to apply the brake to control the vehicles in right way. And the third point is, hold the vehicle still when parked on the flat or a gradient. So when we are parking a vehicle, always we apply the parking brake. Okay, so that brake can hold the vehicle at the same position even if it is in gradient, in some angle, gradient angle. Now coming to the next point, that is the braking system component. What are the braking system components? Here you know the types of brake, that is drum brake, disc brake, okay, regenerative braking, electromagnetic brake. So these are the different kind of brakes, but in general case, the braking system can be divided in some parts as for their working principle, of their working principle. Like number one, the energy source of the braking system. What are the source of energy in a braking system? Obviously, driver support. When you are drive a car, you have to put the effort by using your legs or foot. That means you are giving the effort to the braking system, and your effort can be multiplied by the servo boost system. So servo boost system can increase the effort, driver effort of the braking system. When you apply the servo boost system way braking, you have to put much more less amount of effort to obtain the required for braking. Number two, modulation system to control the braking effort. What are the modulation system to which controls the braking effort? That is driver or moduling valves or ABS valves. Anti-lock braking system. In anti-lock braking system, we are using such kind of modulation system, or this modulating valve we are using to control the better braking effort, control and better braking effort. We are using such modulation system in ABS. Okay, now the transmission system. What are the transmission system of the braking line or braking in? Transmission means you applied the effort, and this effort will going to the shoes, brake shoes. How it goes to the brake shoes? Because of some pipes and linkage that are the transmission system of the braking. That means it transmit your effort to the end line or brake shoes. Okay, so these are the transmission system of the braking. Now next point, friction components. Without friction components, you cannot generate any braking force. or you cannot complete a braking system. So this is the main component of the braking system. So friction component means if we use the drum brake, in drum brake the frictional components are drums and shoes obviously, and is in disc brake, that is disc and pads. So these are the frictional component of the braking system, which creates the friction to retard the vehicle motion. Okay. Now, braking system basics. Now we are going to discuss on some basics of braking systems. Number one, wheel braking torque requirement, that is related to the car weight, tire type, road conditions, such and such. So adjust the braking capacity using paddle and hydraulic mechanical advantage and pad material, rotor size and system stiffness as related to the paddle travel and mechanical, it provides the mechanical advantage. Balance. What is balance? Balance means hydraulic mechanical advantage in front versus rear, balance in the pressure or the pressure bar settings. Okay. Now response linearity. It denotes the temperature operating range and release the characteristics of the pad compound. So these are the some terms. Now, what are the factors affecting in braking efficiency? Number one, grip. So grip means how much frictional force is at the tire in inner side interface. So how much frictional force can generate, that is depends on the grip of the braking. And next one is obviously wheel torque, that is generated through the grip, that depends on the frictional force and wheel radius. And wheel torque is always equals to the braking torque at the point where the wheel lock. Wheel lock is very important because your skidding tendency of the vehicle is totally depend on the wheel lock. So in case of anti-lock braking system, the wheel never locked. So that means internal braking force cannot be exceed the required braking torque or required braking force. So it is always equals or less than the required braking force. When it reach the equal, both are equal, when both are equal, that means the system is sending a signal, please remove your brake or remove your locking position, release your locking position. So at that time your brake shoes release. It is for very fast time and very small time, and due to this process ABS system are working. And now the braking torque depends on the mean radius of the disc friction surface, coefficient of friction at pad or disc interface, and number of friction surfaces. Now the weight transfer. When we are applying the brake, that means your wheels are stopped at that position. If you apply the brakes and in your weight always try to transfer in the forward direction. Usually more weight on the front axle, that's why the more weights are impact on the front axle, and transfer of the weight to the front under the braking. So large braking force can be generated and the front twins, and this achieved by the differentiating pressure to the rear and limiting the valve to reduce the pressure or difference in master cylinder size. Now what are the design has to be avoided, okay, in a braking system? Front wheel lock. The vehicle remains stable but suffered loss of steering control. If your front wheel lock very promptly, that means your control of the vehicle will be lose very fast. So that has to be avoided. And similar case, rear wheel lock. The vehicle becomes unstable and it may go out of the control of driver. Okay, so rear wheel locks, wheel locks has to be avoided for proper braking and safety also. So both wheel lock is very dangerous for a vehicle, and it is mainly when your wheel is locked, your control, your vehicle is not in your control, it is out of control. So you have to resist the wheel lock. And brake fed. What is brake fed? The coefficient of friction will drop if brakes overheated. So heat dissipation important for design consideration. So there is huge heat is generated in the frictional area of the brake. So that heat dissipation is very much or too much important for design consideration. If the brake is overheated, the brake fed will be occurred and that will damage the brake shoe life. And pressure differential between the brakes on the same axle. So pressure difference, say in same axle, right wheels and left wheels, pressure difference should be minimum. It should be equal. Okay, so you have to reduce that pressure difference in between two wheels in same axle. Now what are the design consideration? Now in previous slide we have discussed the what has to be avoided in design. Now design consideration, what we have to consider during starting a design of a braking system. So number one, effective heat dissipation. As I told that the brake fed is due to the high heat generation, so brake fed should not be there. That's why proper heat dissipation is mandatory for the brake shoes or the frictional areas of the brake. And next, multiplication of force multiplication. Force, if we produce some giving some effort of 10 newtons or 1 newtons, and the brakes will apply it at the wheels, that will be 10 newton, that is 10 times. So this multiplication is very much needed by using the servo boost system. Okay, so servo boost system should be operate very promptly and its efficiency should be high. sealing of the system, the leakage of the brake oils should not be considered. That is very unhealthy design. Materials and coefficient of the friction, heat resistance, wear out rate, that are the very important for material selection of a brake. Front and rear force, the weight transfer should not be greater. It should be minimum in weight transfer in front and rear. Variation in operating condition. So in different operating conditions, your working should be different. Okay, that is the also one kind of consideration of the braking. So types of brake. What are the types of brake? One is mechanical brake, hydraulic brake, and power brake. So mechanical brakes are generally the drum brake, and hydraulic brakes are drum brake and disc brake. Disc brakes are not basically mechanical brake. It is almost all principles are mechanical principles, but the working principle of the disc brake cannot be done by mechanically. It should be operated by the hydraulically. Now the power brake, pneumatic brakes, pneumatic hydraulic brakes, vacuum brakes, electric brakes, all are the power brakes which can be used in automobiles. Okay, thank you.